Hi guys, today we are doing physics, electricity part one. Previously I've gone through this video, but let me quickly revise back, revise what we have done before. Now first formula to know is Q equals to IT. Q is total charge, I is current or induction, and time is T. Time must be in seconds, always must change to seconds, minutes cannot. Current is ampere. And total charge is something new called C or Coulomb, Coulomb charge. So symbol is the C, Coulomb charge. So that's your first formula, Q equals to IT. All right. So the next one we probably have seen before is V is equals to IR, Ohm's law. So this is Ohm's law. Form 3 of Ohm's law, you have studied this. Okay. Ohm's law, you must know this formula. Now, there's one more formula for Q, because Q is actually total charge. Total charge can also be equals to number of charges, N, times each one charge, each one, each electron or each positive charge. So either can be NQ or NE. E stands for electron charge, Q stands for positive charge. This stands for total charge. It means this formula and this formula represents Q. All right. So the value for Q is 1.6 times 10 power negative 19 coulomb. You can actually get it from your calculator. So this is a positive value. And the value for the electron is negative 1.6 times 10 power negative 19 coulomb. Also, you must know this. It's inside your scientific calculator. You can actually get it. Now, V stands for potential difference, all right, potential difference, or in simple words, we call it voltage or volt. I is current, R is resistance. Resistance should be in ohm. This is the symbol for ohm, all right, ohm, and this is ampere, A, this is ohm. So these three formulas are quite important for basic calculations, all right. Now, how do we use this stuff? All right, the first thing is we need to know how to use it in a parallelly arranged resistors. You see, like this. Okay. So let's say I have 2 ohms here, and then I have 3 ohms here, and then I have 6 ohms here. Right? And this is, let's say, 12 volts, 12 volt battery. So in this case, the current is going to flow this way. The current is going to flow this way. Once it reaches here, the current will actually break or split into 3 parts. So this is IO, this is I1, this is I2, this is I3. Okay. So this is understood. So the first thing you need to know is the total current of all these three must be equals to the main current. So that's your understanding here. That's the total current. Now the point number two, which is very important and always they'll ask you is, you see, using the Ohm's law, V equals to IR. So between this two, let's say A and B, this is C and D. Let's call this EF. Now, from A to B, there will be what we call as a potential difference, volt, potential difference. So VAB, here in a parallel diagram, the voltage must be same in all the branches. In all the parallel branch, the voltage must be same. Meaning, here we have 12 volt. That means here to here must also be 12 volt. Here to here must also be 12 volt. Here to here must also be 12 volt. Can you see that? So that's one of the most important thing in a parallel circuit. Parallel circuit, right? So that means, in other words, how do we find the voltage here? The voltage must use this formula, V equals to IR. take the I one times this 2 ohms resistance, you must get 12. So in other words, I times 2 must give you 12, which means I1 will be 6. So I1, so what's our Ohm's law? V equals to IR. So which means V is already 12. Why is it 12? Why is it 12? Because it's parallel. So therefore V equals to 12. I1 is here times the R is 2. I1 times 2, you're going to get, what's I? So you're going to get 6 amperes. So same thing here, this times this is going to give you 12. So what is I2? Very simple, isn't it? I2 must be 4 times 3, giving you 12. So this is 4 ampere. And so here, what times what is going to give you 12? So here must be 2 times 6, 2 times 6. So therefore, this is going to be 2 amperes. As simple as that. But what's the basic understanding? What's the basic understanding? Get this into your head. Every parallel circuit must have the same voltage. Now, that means this current, if you add up 6 plus 4 plus 2, your current now is 12 ampere, which means 12 ampere flows down through here. You understood? So this is the first thing you need to understand in a parallel circuit. Now, the other thing which you probably have learned in Form 3 is how to find the total resistance. The total resistance in a parallel circuit is, you must do like this, the total resistance, total, must be equals to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. And then please find this. You do yourself, all right? In this case, you will probably get 1 ohm. You do it yourself and check it out, all right? So that means you just take 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 6. Now, don't forget, after that, you must flip it over because the RO is at the bottom. So once you get an answer, flip it over, all right? Make sure you get RO. So I leave this to you. You please find this out. Are you okay? All right? Now, good. Next, let's move on into a series circuit. All right? The series circuit is slightly different. So I'm going to change it again. All right? I'm going to erase this off. The series circuit. Now, series means all the resistors are in a straight line. They don't have any branches, okay? So let's try this out now, okay? I'm going to do that. Okay, something like this. So I'm going to put one resistor here, two resistor here, and three resistor here, third resistor, all right? So let's put it as 2 ohms, okay? Let's put as 4 ohms, and let's put as 4, 6, 8, let's put as 12 ohms. I've got 3 resistors. So R1, R2, R3. So here, the total resistance, will be just add up only, because this is called a series circuit, series. It's not parallel, series. So it's R1 plus R2 plus R3. Very simple. This plus this plus this. You're going to get 18 ohms absolutely direct. Now, the next point you must understand is the current which flows here is the same current throughout. That means the same current flows here, the same current flows here, the same current flows here, same current flows up. Unlike parallel, in parallel, the current has split. Here it doesn't split. Same current, okay? So that's important for you to understand. Now, in parallel circuit, what we learned? In parallel circuit, we learned voltage is same in all three branches. That means, in other words, if you have three branches like that, the voltage here, this part, that means here will be 12 volt, here 12 volt, all 12 volts. But here's different. Here, the voltage will break according to the ratio. That means using this formula, V is directly proportional to R. So the higher the resistor, more voltage has to be supplied to them. So in other words, if you take a look at the ratio, what's the ratio here? 2, 4, 12. That means ratio is, let's take a look. 2, 4, 12, what's the ratio? 1 divided by 2, divided by 2, 6. So the 12 volt will be broken up according to this ratio. That's one way of doing it, right? The other way of doing it is, 12, what is the total resistance? Total resistance is this. So let's use our formula V equals to IR. 12 is your volt. Your current is now unknown. We need to find. Your total resistance is 18. So please divide. What do you get? So when you divide, you're going to get I is equals to 12 over 18. You're going to get 2 over 3 amperes. Which means 2 over 3 ampere is actually flowing through here. So now if I put in a voltmeter here, a voltmeter, the voltmeter will all show me different readings. Why? Eh? What's the reason? Because I told you that the V, the voltage, is proportional to the R. The bigger the R, the more the voltage. So how do you find this? Very simple. This is your I. The I is coming in. So I times R. What's your I times R? 2 over 3 times 2. So let's find out what is V1. V1 is I is 2 over 3 times 2. So your voltage will be 4 over 3 volts. That's the reading here. Then the same current passes through here. So again, the I times R. So what's V2? V2 will be I times R, which is 8 over 3 ampere. The same current passes through here. That means V3, what's my V3 voltage? 2 over 3 times 12. 2 over 3 is the current I, times R is 12. You will get 24 over 3 amperes. Add up volt. So add up all three, add up this volt. Add up this, what do you get? Add up this, and add up this. You will get 12 volt again. So the total volt must be 12. In this case, different. In this case, the 12 volt is given to each circuit. Are you okay? Each parallel branch. Okay, so I hope you're all right. So what is different here? To calculate the resistor, you just add up straight. To calculate the resistor here, R is different. You need to use this formula, 1 over R formula. All right, so this is our formula, 1 over R, 1 over R3, and so on. So the formula is different. The second concept which is different is, current, same current. Here the current splits. That's the second thing. All right. The third thing is, voltage is according to resistor. But here, the voltage is same in every branch. Are you okay? So this is on part one. All right. So wait for part two video. All right. Thank you so much.